Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. This video series will show you some digital beauty retouching techniques. We will proceed through a workflow where we will go from this to this. We'll look at everyday tasks such as spot removal, removing lines, and skin smoothing. The end idea is to retain a youthful and refreshed look without creating a porcelain doll. If you would like to follow along, please click the link in the YouTube description to download the media. If you are watching the podcast version of this video, then type the link displayed in your internet browser. Now let's get started. Here we have a shot of Matt, who was filmed in front of a green screen. The background is irrelevant, as we will just be working on his face. Let's jump straight into Connect Effects and start applying the treatments. The first step in this process is to remove the grain from the shot. Go to the Connect Effects node bin and press D for denoise. Drop the denoise node into the connection. You'll notice that there is also a degrain node in the node bin. This also does degraining based on various film stocks, but the denoise tool is my preferred weapon of choice because of its analysis tools. Now, why remove the grain? Well, technically, grain is created as images are captured via the sensor. For this type of beauty work, the grain could cause issues later in the workflow. However, aesthetically speaking, grain gives the image its texture. And compositing clean CGI with live action, grain should always be added to complete the integration of the elements. Beauty work is no different. Once we have done all the beauty retouching, we will add the grain back to the shot. Just ensure all your sources are 16-bit float, because we will be using the float space when re-adding the grain. Now double-click on the denoise node. Click Add to create an analysis box. Just click and place it on a flat shade of color. You also might want to zoom very tight into your image to see the results. Click Analyze, and smoke will degrain the image. You can toggle the bypass button to see the before and after. A tip regarding degraining. You can add multiple analysis boxes to sample the grain in the highlights, midtones, and shadows. You do this to control grain in different levels of brightness in the image. Now I will select the node and rename it to Remove Grain. I will be renaming nodes as I go along, just to keep track of what I'm doing. Degraining can be quite an intense process, so I suggest creating a CFX clip to cache what we have got so far. Right-click on the node and choose Create CFX. This new CFX clip is currently unrendered, so to cache it, select and right-click it. Choose Render and process the clip. This will speed up the pipeline when working. Remember that you can always explode it out if you need to get back to the original settings. So tidying up the Connect Effects schematic, we are left with the original media and the cached degrained CFX clip. In the next video, we'll perform spot removal treatment. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning Channel for future videos.